All right, folks, let's stand. We're going to pray. What's needed? Up you go, guys. Go away. It's good. Roll the shoulders back. Okay, ready? Inhale. Breath hold. And birthday candle. Ready? Inhale. Breath hold. And exhale. You guys at home, unmute. You guys all together. Out loud, let's pray. Teach me your way, Lord, that I might rely on your faithfulness. Give me an undivided heart, that I might fear your name. Amen. Got your cell phones or your planners. Your homework tonight, guys, either put it in your cell phone or planners, is preview video 7.2 part 2. So it's a continuation of inscribed angles. That's mostly application stuff. You're going to need post-it notes handy for the next several lessons. So make sure you have post-it notes close by. I gave you one set in your preview notes. I recommend next time you're at Office Depot or Walmart to actually get yourself a stack of these if you don't have some. Okay? That's your homework. You guys at home, text message me. Why, in what way is this dog inscribed? You guys, talk to each other. In what way is this dog inscribed? Go. In what way is this dog inscribed? Go. What makes it inscribed? Mm-hmm. What makes this dog inscribed? Yeah, insight. Ready, today's lesson, no calculators, friends. Everything we're doing is two-digit addition and subtraction, so no calculators. Let's go to your reference booklet. Let's just get the basics down real quick. I'll give you about 20 seconds to find this page in your reference booklet. It's unit 7. There's your thumb here. Your thumb.
Oh.
Keep going. There you go. Right there. All righty. Students, those of you who came in tardy, we are on your reference booklet. Last class was this. We had a central angle. So eyeball the center. And then we called it a pizza slice angle. Hi there. And we learned this, that the angle is the same as the arc. The angle is the same as the arc. That was the central angle. That was the main event of yesterday's lesson. Angle equals arc. We're in our reference booklet, Laura. Reference booklet. Your reference booklet is like your physical reference booklet. Okay, the left side of the black rack is an extra sheet. Now, the next two angles, the vertex is on the circle. It's not in the center, it's on. No, not that one. On the far left, right there. So write the word on. Whenever you have an on, that's where you're going to be using your post-it notes, just to give you a heads up. If an angle has the same position, it has the same equation. So since both of these are on, it's going to share the same equation. So put a little caret there, same position, same equation. An inscribed angle looks like this. The arms are in. And we learned that that angle is half of the arc it's grabbing, half. That's an inscribed angle. Bring your reference booklet, Jordan. Reference booklet. Okay. A tan chord is also an on. So draw yourself a tangent and draw yourself a chord. I'm going to get really close. I'm going to be kind of color coding this. So a tan chord is also angle equals half the arc, but watch very carefully. You have, see this arc, squiggle arc? This angle here is half of that arc facing that way. So squiggle, squiggle. That angle is half of that arc. And then if I go this way, this dashed angle is going to be half of this dashed arc. So in a tan chord, technically there's two angles and two different arcs, and they're both just right half of. What's in common is that the vertex is on, the vertex is on. Same position, same equation. Hold up four fingers. You guys hold up four fingers. Repeat after me. Say same position, same equation. You guys at home, unmute. Say that with me. Ready? And same. You guys at home, unmute. Say it with me. Same position. Same equation. Okay. Now to help you memorize this, we have a song. And yes, you're singing. You're so singing, especially you guys in class. Okay. So it goes like this. I sing, you're going to catch on. Measure of a central angle to its arc the same. The smaller angle of inscribed is half the arc, it's plain. A tan chord angle is the same as the one inscribed. Yes, there's a comma there. Use it, people. It's the middle of a sentence. It annoys you. It's okay. Get over it. Ready? You guys. Full throttle. Ready? Sing. Measure of a central angle to its arc the same. The smaller angle of inscribed is half the arc, it's plain. A tan chord angle is the same as the one inscribed. There you go. We're dealing just with this today. Go to the first page of today's lesson. First page of today's lesson. You are now looking at this, friends. So taking a look here, has anyone, you guys in class, has anyone used a hex wrench lately? A hex wrench? Yeah? Like a normal hex wrench? Yeah? Okay, so in this case, this hexagon, if you can trace it, you can see it. This hexagon is inscribed in the circle. That is an illustration of an inscribed hexagon. You just want to draw an illustration in the side margin, you can. Now, angles, an inscribed angle has three properties, very important. Number one, the vertex is on the circle. The vertex is on the circle. Trace this, trace the arms. The arms are in the circle. That's why it's called inscribed. And I imagine at the end here are hands. Forgive me, you artists, this is the best I can do. The hands grab the far arc. And what you learned here is that this angle is half of that. We're going to do real simple example here. So step number one, I'd like you to trace the central angle CAB. Darken the center, CAB. That's a central angle. I'd like you to put 120 there, 120. Okay, ready? You guys at home, complete my sentence. Measure of a central angle to its arc, the
same.
Nice, yeah, so if this is 120, that means this arc out here is also 120 degrees. We have an on right there. That means this angle, CRB. Chloe, what would be the measure of CRB? 60, you got it, equals 60 degrees. Now you have another arm right here. I'd like you to trace with me E, D, and CB. That's a tangord. And we're gonna trace ECB. That's a tangord angle, ECB. ECB. Jimmy, what would be the measure of this angle right here if it's an on? It's grabbing 120. What would be the measure back here?
Would it be 60?
It would be, yes. Because remember, same position, same equation. You got it. Good. Turn the page, folks. I'm going to give you a little push in the right direction. Okay. Jurian, could you read our four bullets? Go out loud.
Open on the on vertex frame on the inscribed angles. Good. Find all areas. Go back and find additional inscribed angles. Look for vertical angles and triangles.
Fabulous job figuring out my typos there. Kudos. So step number one, I'm going to get you halfway through this. I want you to darken all the ons and write the word on. Darken all the ons. Now, get your post-its handy. You guys, you didn't get post-its. All of you guys need to walk up here quickly, a couple at a time, either side, get two post-its, go. Okay, you can't go all at once, quickly. Grab two post-its, go back. You can come over here, on the right, two post-its. Laura, two post-its, go back. Two post-its. Yes, you feel the need to use hand sanitizer, there's hand sanitizer in the back. Two post-its, you need post-its, back. Just a moment, post-its, Chloe, come get post-its. Guys, hang on to those post-its. You guys at home, if you have post-its or you have the post-its from the preview note, that would be very helpful. Very helpful. Mr. Ross, do you have post-its? Hudson, you have post-its? Okay, great. Let me show you what I mean by flaming, folks. Okay, ready? D is an on. So I want you to put your post-its around D. Don't lay them down, just kind of hold them. We're going to move very fast. That's what I mean by framing. Ready? Now go just to the left. That's another inscribed angle. So right now we have two inscribed angles. I'm going clockwise. Ready? Frame at A. That's your third inscribed angle. Go to the left of A. There's your fourth inscribed angle. You see how there's a lot of them, folks. Come to B. Move your post-its to B. That's your fifth inscribed angle. Go to the right of B. There's your sixth inscribed angle. Frame at C. There's your seventh. Frame at C again. There's your eighth. You have eight inscribed angles. Watch out for all of those. I'm going to do only two of them with you, and then I'm going to cut you loose for 2 minutes. Step number one, I'd like you to frame it D. Frame it D. Ready? I'd like you to sweep the angle and then follow out the framing and sweep the arc it's grabbing. Sweep the angle, sweep the arc. I'm going to ask a question. I'm going to land on someone in about 30 seconds. Not 30 seconds, 3 seconds. If this is 60, what is this? 3, 2, 1. Jory, what's out here? If this is inscribed, it's half of the arc. Bingo. There you go. That's going to be 120. The next one I want you to frame, I want you to frame at C. All right. Sweep the angle, sweep the arc. This is also inscribed. Ready? 3 seconds. Find the measure of that angle. 3, 2, 1. Amelia, what's back here, ma'am? It's inscribed, which means it's half. It's not central, it's half. It's an inscribed angle.
Oh, so
it's half.
So 45.
There you go. 45. Yes. All of the ons are going to be half. You have 2 minutes to find all possible arcs and angles on your own. No calculators. Go. Use your post-it notes. 2 minutes. Do whatever you can on your own. I will go over it in 2 minutes. Keep framing, keep using those post-its. Devin, you can find more. There's more there, use your post-its. There's more there. Keep using your post-its, guys. Everywhere where there's an on, you can use your post-its. And when you use your post-it notes, it's half of the arc. Your goal is to try to find all possible arcs and angles. All possible arcs and angles. Warning, these angles right here where my finger's at, those are not central. That's the center of the circle. Those are not central. Just be careful with that. Okay, pay attention, guys. I'm going to be calling on nearly 12 of you. We're going to go real fast here. And then you're going to text back to me what you got right, how much of it you got right, and what did you overlook. So step number one, here's the main thing. Put your finger on B. Let's go clockwise. 120, 96, 90. You're missing something. Huh? Chloe, what did you get for that? And how'd you get it? Yeah, that's important, guys. Always try to find arcs before angles, if at all possible. And the most frequently overlooked thing is simply the fact that circles add up to 360. Now that you have all the arcs, it is super easy to pick off these inscribed angles. Let's frame it D. like this, frame it D, and I'm looking for that red angle. Edwin, what would this angle be back here, sir, if this is 54?
I didn't get that one.
Well, tell us how you would get it.
I'll divide 54 by 2.
Let's do it. 54 divided by 2. 2 goes in there twice. It goes into 14.
7.
Okay, so half of 54 is?
27.
Beautiful. 27. Continuing to walk. Let's go to A. A, and this is 96. Right back here, 3 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Okay, Sophia, what'd you get back here? Forty-eight is correct. Yes, very good. Okay, ready? Keep walking it around. Let's come to A. Let's come to A. Right here, that's A. It's grabbing this right here. And Ryan, what do you get? If this is 120, what's back here?
60.
Bingo, 60. Okay, let's go to B, moving it to B. Once again, we're just wandering around. Taking a look here, sweep the right here and the 90. McKenna, what's back here, ma'am? 45, nice job. Keep go to the right with the post-it notes. Post-it note. Get that angle for us, please. Jurian, this angle back here. Look at where my thumb is. That'll help.
48.
48 it is. Nice job. 48. Go to C. Frame C up. We're just walking all the way around here. Framing up C. Kelly, what'd you get for C, ma'am?
27.
27. Okay, now check all your ons. We have all the ons, but wait, there's more in class. What are we missing? The middle ones. Warning, that is not central angles. But we have a bunch of triangles here. Students, I'm going to give you 20 seconds. You're going to find, I'm going to call this angle 1 and angle 2, angle 3, and angle 4. Go. You got 20 seconds. McKenna, is there anything else that you did? Okay, then the phone goes away. No, I want the phone off the desk, please. Thank you, ma'am. We're doing TJ's addition and subtraction. So, wonderful. Lua, what'd you get for angle 1? 60. We're going to go 48 and 27. That gets us 75. Okay, that you just grabbed the right one. Okay, so 75 away from 180. What'd you get? 75 away from 180? 75 away from 180. Okay. Beautiful. 105. And Mateo Ross, if this is 105, what's over here at angle 2? No, straight across. 105. What do we call those? Beautiful job. Beautiful job. Mr. Sanchez, what would be angle 3 and 4 there for?
75.
75 it is. Yes, and more vertical angles. Okay, this is what I want you to do. You guys at home, I would like you to send me a text. Which angle did you overlap? You guys in class, we're going to do this. You're going to go like this. You're going to show me with your fingers. 10 means I found literally everything just like you, Miss Way. 9 would be like I missed one angle and then take it down from there. I want you to tell me how much of this did you find on your own? Did you get a 10? Did you get an 8? And a 9? All righty, guys. Okay, you have 20 minutes. Fabulous job. Fabulous job. Good. Good. Most of you got most of them. I get it. The central angles. You only have 2 pages now, guys, and you have basically 18 minutes to do 2 pages. So go to town, folks. Go to town. You are working on the next 2 pages on your own. If you need help, just give me a holler and I'll pull you into a breakout room. If you look carefully, the instructions on the page literally walk you through the problem. For example, I tell you to frame X, that means your post-it should go somewhere like this. Post-it, post-it. That's what I mean by framing, folks. Hudson, are you done already?
Yeah.
You're done? Oh, okay. You're checking your answers now?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, great. Can you just hold up your last page so I can see how much of it you got on your own? Okay. Did you find all the angles?
Yep.
Yeah. Fabulous. Okay, go check. If you got a link to a breakout room, could you click on it for me, please? Students, can you check to see if you got a link to a breakout room, please? Oh, kiddo. Okay, so put your name under the red list. See the red light? You got to put your name on the list, date, time, color pen, and then poke your head out the door. If there's absolutely not a single human soul down to the left, you can go to the left, the men's restroom. If there's anyone down the hallway, you have to go to the right of that. Jurian, I'm just checking, buddy. You're on my slot to be here every day. Is being at home temporary?
Yeah, I stayed at home because so like I had a camp and then the other day, like I woke up very sore, like I barely was able to move. So I just stayed home.
Got it. Okay. So it's just you can't move very well. I get it. All right. You just want to make it temporary. Got it. Thank you.
Yeah. So I'll be there tomorrow though.
Looking forward to it. You bet.
Yeah. All right.
Student, you're on the last page and you'd like some help. Send me a quick text. I'll happily pull you into a breakout room and go over that last page with you. Is there anyone here? And you're on the last page and you're having a hard time? Amelia, you doing okay? Cameron?
Yeah, I'm good.
Dylan, Edwin, questions on that last page?
I'm doing good.
I'm fine.
Okay. Jimmy, Kelly?
No.
I'm doing good, thank you.
All right. Lauren, Mr. Sanchez?
I'm doing fine, thank you.
I'm good.
All right. Brian, questions? Devin, do you have questions on the last page? You do? Okay. Lua, questions on the last page?
Oh, no, I'm good.
You're working on that one? Okay. Zach, you doing okay? Good? Sophia, making sense? Okay. Do you notice there's a diameter there?
Yes.
Good. That comes in handy. Okay, so what do you have? What are you missing? I guess it's an easier one.
The diameter bisected.
So are you saying you're missing this angle right here?
So
you're missing these angles back here?
Yeah, I'm missing that angle.
Mm-hmm.
And then
up these angles?
Yeah.
Okay, so I guess my first question is, did you get the measure of this arc? What'd you get? 88 is correct, okay. And then what's the measure of this arc? Okay, so I'd like you to frame, using your post-its, frame this orange angle, frame it. You see that's inscribed? Okay, so sweep the 68 and sweep the arc it's grabbing. You see that pretty much solves everything?
Yes.
Yes, yes it does. Sure, you bet. Sorry, question? No? Okay, are you working on the preview notes? Good choice. Make sure you have post-it notes handy. Loa, any questions on the last problem? Kira, you good?
Yeah. I got a question.
Fabulous. Edwin, yes, give me a job. I appreciate it. What's that?
So for the last one, there, the angle in the very center of everything, I can't figure out how to find any of those angles.
Okay, well, so let's just double check that you have like everything else. Okay, what is the measure of this arc P to N?
136.
Okay, and the arc M to N?
I haven't gotten that one because I wasn't able to find the one that's under the green angle.
Okay, you see that little red dot?
Yeah.
That red dot? Put your finger at P.
Yeah.
Okay, now sweep along the edge of the circle, go all the way to M.
Okay.
What do you know about that? What's true?
It's 180.
Ah, there you be. So find MN.
Okay.
Kelly, you doing okay?
Huh?
I was talking to Kelly. Kelly, you doing okay?
Yeah, I'm doing good. I'm just leaving right now.
Okay. Bye, girl. Edwin, let me know when you get that arc.
44.
Beautiful. Okay. So now you have all the arcs. You always want to try to go for the arcs before the angles, if at all possible.
Yeah.
Okay. So do you have all the arcs? Just kind of like put your finger around. You got all the arcs?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's go for the angles now.
Okay.
So this red angle here is what?
I didn't get that one yet.
Okay. Frame it up. It's inscribed. Do you see that?
Yeah, I know.
On. It's going to be half the arc it's grabbing.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Sorry. 68.
Huh?
68.
68 is correct. Okay. Now let's come to framing again. I'd like you to frame the angle M and L going this way. You see it?
Yeah, I do.
Okay, frame it up.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
And then what's going to be the measure of this angle back here? At N.
N. 44.
Beautiful. Okay. What about, did you already get, you probably already got this yellow angle.
Yeah, 46.
46, you got it. Good. Now, coming down here, this angle right here is inscribed as well. You see that?
Yeah, that would be 22.
Thank you.
Beautiful. Now you're getting the hang of it. This angle's inscribed.
What?
What's this angle?
Which one? That would be 44.
44. You already got the 68. Let's see if you got all your inscribed angles. I think you did now. Let's just double check. On, you got that one. You got that one, that one, that one. You're good there. You're good there. You're good. Okay, we're good. Now you're like, how do I get these guys in the middle, right? Okay. What shape?
Which one?
What shape did I just highlight?
Triangle.
Beautiful. Triangle that up to?
180.
There you go. I think you got it from there.
Thank you.
Because that's 46, that's 22. You can take it from there.
Mm-hmm.
Good job. Brian, Darian, questions first. Yep, you all good? Lauren, ma'am?
Yeah, I'm good.
Jimmy, Cameron, questions?
I'm good.
I'm okay.
All righty. Lua, did you correct your work? Sebastian, fabulous.
Thank you, Ms. Ware.
Bye now. Ryan, Jerry, and Cameron, if you think you know what you're doing, you're welcome to exit and finish on your own, but I'll happily stick around to see if you need help.
Thank you, bye.
Uh-huh, bye. Oops, I thought I was turning this off.